From Epworth, John Wesley goes to London at age 11 to attend Charterhouse School. Wesley completes his schooling there and enrolls in 1720 at Christ Church in Oxford. That's 90 minutes to the west of London.
We did. We went to Oxford and visited both Christ Church, where John Wesley was ordained, and we visited the college where he was in school. It was at Oxford that Wesley, we like to use the phrase, John Wesley was a campus minister. As a student, he and others joined together in a holy club. They visited incarcerated people in prison. They were engaged in ministries of social holiness in Oxford, and they began there to sort of agitate the established church because of the ways in which they were reaching out to all people.
Once ordained, Wesley begins intense reading that leads him to order his life, waking at 4 a.m., reading scripture daily, taking communion routinely. After spending time at Epworth assisting his father with a church, Wesley returns to Oxford, where he finds his brother Charles meeting routinely with a small group of men, the Holy Club. I talked with Kate Dobson at Wesley Memorial Methodist Church in Oxford about Wesley and the Holy Club.
But they were very, very disciplined. You have to understand that the Church of England at that time had a fairly lax approach to religious observance. And if you went to communion three times a year, that was okay. Now, the Wesley brothers didn't really rate that much. They thought that was pretty poor. And they and their friends went to communion every week. And they met every night to study and to pray. And they prayed every hour for a short time. So they were extremely disciplined. Word got out, and the powers that be in Oxford didn't really like this. It was enthusiasm. And enthusiasm in the 18th century is a bad word because it means fanaticism. And that's when the names came up, Methodists and Bible moths and all sorts of other rude names. They were really meant to be rude, of which John Wesley selected the word Methodist later to represent what he meant by being a Christian and being well organized and being serious about your faith. The other stuff that they did, I mean, they didn't just sit around and be holy together. They visited the poor, they took food to poor people, they visited people in prison. They were generally very good at what now we would call social work. So they were determined, motivated, and disciplined. And I think that Wesley's ability to organise that at that time, when he wasn't actually very old, I mean, he was only 26 or 27, stood him in good stead for later when he was actually getting these small societies around the country going.